Okay, good evening, students. I welcome you for the question answer sessions for the CBSC sample papers. They are very important and essential under the existing conditions. Our preparation should be good, and our purpose is to give a complete revision of the course through these question answer sessions, and also to give you sufficient amount of practice, students. And we have before us certain important questions which have been taken from some sample paper student. Again, the following questions, 17 to 25, are short time and carry 1 or 2 marks, students. In the following pair of halogen compounds, which will undergo SN1 reaction faster? Let me tell you, student, in the alkyl halides, students, what is the most important reaction? Tell me. This is all revision of the course, student. Which is the most important reaction of haloalkanes, students? What is that called? Nucleophilic
substitution reactions.
Okay, be with me, students. Revision of the course. Nucleophilic substitution. What are the two different types of nucleophilic substitution reaction, students?
SN1 and SN2.
SN1 and SN2, students. Because question could be on different way as we are discussing. What is the difference between SN1 and SN2, students?
Sir, SN1 is based on carbocation stability.
What is the order of reactivity?
Tertiary greater than secondary greater than primary.
Okay. Order of reactivity, 3 degree more than 2 degree more than 1 degree. And what is the SN2, students? What is the order of reactivity?
Primary greater than secondary greater than tertiary.
What is the main reason?
It is based upon the steric hindrance.
Steric hindrance. Because in the exam, these words will be required. Correct answer half and reason half, like this. Only one word. You don't have to write much. So we are aware of these. Can you tell me, student, what is the stereochemistry? Because there are more questions on that in SN1, SN2. Students, stereochemical aspects of SN1. What happens in SN1, student? What will happen?
Racemic mixture.
If the compound is chiral.
If the compound is chiral, then we'll get a racemic mixture.
Racemic mixture. And in SN2, student, if the compound is chiral,
inversion of configuration.
Inversion. This question has been put up so many times. What is a chiral molecule, students?
Optically active molecules which have one asymmetric carbon.
Optically active. Chiral means it has, don't say optically active, give that condition of the chirality is that the molecule should have asymmetric carbon.
One asymmetric carbon at least.
So that means carbon should be attached to 4 different groups. So when we say condition, be clear. Because student, in reasoning and assertion type of question, you have seen one word will make a difference. Okay. And you have seen the choices where A is right, B is right, but other B is the reason for A. That is the main point where some confusion exists. You have seen, you have experienced it. That is good, because we will be doing practice of assertion reasoning more, because more questions are coming on that. And that gives us a more detailed revision, and basic concepts become very clear. All these questions are doing what, student? What are we doing? Why are we doing? Again, our basic concepts will become clear. Because I'm talking of the basic concept, student, no rattabaji. That is not going to work. So unless we have complete knowledge, how will we answer question? No, we can't. So in the following pairs of halogen compound, which will undergo SN1 faster? What is the answer, students? This is a compound. This is another compound. So
second compound will be faster.
This one is faster. Why, student?
So because it has it is secondary in nature.
SN1. So it is 2 degree haloalkane. Okay.
Yes,
okay. Sir. How do I write answer? 2 degree haloalkane and this. So among us, the isomeric dihalobenzenes, which has the highest melting point, and why? Now, isomeric dihalobenzene, student. Now, for how many isomers are there for the disubstituted benzene, student? How many isomers are possible?
Three.
Okay. Let us see what are those three, students. Everything to be worked out, student. We don't give anything short. Very clear of the thing, student. How do we write? How do we write students? You have 1,2, 1,3, and 1,4 dichlorobenzene. What is this called? Ortho?
Ortho metapara.
Para. What is our answer?
Sir, para isomer will have the highest melting point.
Para has the highest melting point. What reason we are giving students?
Because it is symmetrical in nature and fits in the crystal lattice.
Symmetric fits
in the crystal lattice.
Fits closely, or what we say? Fits closely in the crystal lattice. ठीक है, हाफ मार्क एंड हाफ इट बिकम्स वन. सी द मार्किंग हाउ इट इज बीइंग डन. हाफ ऑफ मार्क्स यू आर गेटिंग विच विल हैव अ हायर बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. 1-chloroethane एंड 2-chloromethyl ब्यूटेन गिव रीजन. बट फर्स्ट आई शुड बी एबल टू ड्रा द स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ द स्टूडेंट. व्हाट इज दैट? 1-chloro 1-chloroethane, 1,2-1-chloroethane. Students, this is my 1-chloroethane, and the next one is 2-chloro-2-methylbutane. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2-chloro-2-methyl. What answer we are giving students?
It will be higher boiling point.
One of the question on boiling point is usually asked to student in the paper. We have experienced this many times.
1-chloroethane will have a higher boiling point.
Answer is wrong, students. Can you see one big thing here? What is the, there are factors when we discuss, but here you see that this molecule,
number of carbon atoms,
are a molecular mass is so large. Can you see how big is the difference in the molecular mass? So, van der Waal force, students, directly proportional to molecular mass. When the molecular masses are same, then we will see the other points. But here you can see that which has a bigger molecular mass, students. So the boiling point of this will be very high as compared to this. Further, students, because the reason student got the point, questions are like that. Half and half, students. 18.1 molar solution of glucose and sodium chloride respectively, which will have a higher boiling point, and why, students? This question has been asked many times, in many ways. What is that? What we are trying to say? Which chapter is this, students?
Solutions.
Okay, let me say solutions, students. I have a complete picture in my mind. Solution. What I am talking of? Elevation
and boiling point.
What type of property is this, students?
Colligative property.
Colligative property. What are colligative properties, students?
Those properties which depend upon the number of constituent particles rather than their nature.
Okay, depends on the concentration, you are saying. Okay, then what is the story here? 0.01 molar glucose and sodium chloride, which will have higher boiling point?
Sodium chloride will have a higher boiling point.
NaCl. Why?
Because it is an ionic solid, so it will dissociate into ions.
It will dissociate into ion. So this will give rise to, student, one particle, 1+1, 2. So how much elevation you are expecting, student? How much value will change?
By 2, I is equal to 2.
डेल्टा टी भी आई इंटू के एफ इंटू एम स्टूडेंट्स, तो द वांटा फैक्टर इज टू, देन डेल्टा टी बी विल बी ट्वाइस ऑफ दैट. क्लियर? समटाइम्स दे आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट. सी देयर इज अ वैरायटी ऑफ क्वेश्चन, वन क्वेश्चन एंड मैनी अदर पॉसिबिलिटीज, बिकॉज दिस क्वेश्चन विल बी चेंज्ड. How it will be changed? Then he will ask you, how much is the elevation in the boiling point? Four choices will be given, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have to answer one of the four MCQ questions. How they are put up, student? MCQ question. We are going to discuss that also, because I will be discussing physical chemistry questions separately, inorganic and organic also. Very important for NEET also. They will be important for the competition also. And there will be questions from NEET also. So students, what we are talking, delta TB is equal to I. So that is our point. Our answer is clear, student. We already said NaCl is the answer. And this dissociates to give two ions. The number of particle increases. The number of ions increase almost double. Why is an increase in temperature observed on mixing chloroform and acetone? Chloroform and acetone, student, what happens if you mix them? The temperature is increased.
Yes, sir.
Why it increases? All these questions are important, student. All these questions are important, students.
It will form a. It will show negative deviation from Rayleigh's
law. Will it be negative or what? What is, we have to be sure about what we are talking.
It will be negative deviation.
We have to show. Let me see that. This what is happening, students. This is an important question. Questions are important in this topic. Okay. What is the question? Where is chloroform? CHCl. CLCl. Where is acetone? C double bond O. CH3. That is the position. So what is happening? This is electron withdrawing group, students. Electron. So there is a lot of positive here, a lot of positive here. There is a lot of negative here. So what will happen, student? There will be formation of intermolecular hydrogen bond. Attractive force increases. When attractive force increases, what will happen? Attractive force increases between the molecules. There will be release of energy. Right?
Yes, sir.
So whenever attractive force increases, there will be increase in energy, students. And due to this, what will happen? This AB interactions stronger than AA and BB. So this will release energy. Therefore, student, there will be increase in temperature, because everything requires a reason, student. Even exceptions are not exceptions. There is a reason for that. So got my point? When we say it is exception, there is a reason for that, student, if we go and understand it. So that is not an exception. No exception. Everything has a reason. Everything has a reason. Everything has some meaning and a concept is involved. Okay. Describe the type of hybridization for the complex ion. Student, what is the hybridization? Now, how do we find the hybridization, student? What you are talking about valence bond theory.
Yes, sir.
VBT. Okay, you have 1 minute. 1 minute to answer the question. Very, very important question is this, students. You know that they will ask you hybridization on the basis of valence bond theory. You have had in the coordination compound, student, Werner theory only talked of primary and secondary valences, gave no information about the geometry, why complexes are formed, or the magnetic property, student. The valence bond theory was given based on the hybridization, and that is the question. Good is a good question. Good question, student. Such questions are going to be there in the paper.
It is coming out to be it is SP3D2.
SP3D2.
Yes, sir.
Is it high spin or low spin complex? So many questions can be there on this. So many questions. I'm finding space for this because this is an important question. Questions will be changed in the paper and valence bond theory, student, a revision of that. Very important question is coming from coordination compounds in all the competitions also. Huge applications, yes. Large application, okay, large application. Let me see. FeH2O6. What is the atomic number of iron, students?
26.
26. 4S2, 3D6. What is the oxidation number of iron, students?
Here it is Fe2+.
Plus 2. So Fe2+ means the D count is 3D6. 3D6, how do I write 3D6, students? How do I write 3D6? Very important. I have to, these are 2 marks question. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Be with me. Pay attention, student. Pay attention. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Now, the question is, you have a ligand is water. What type of ligand is water? Generally, student, you have some idea about it.
It is a
will weak, it pair up? Will it pair it, up? It these? Because there is a possibility of pairing of, student. If it pairs up, can it pair up, students?
It will not pair up.
It will not pair up. I'm saying water is a
weak field ligand.
It doesn't have the energy. It doesn't have the power, students, to pair up. Pairing will require energy. Who will give the energy? The ligand. Ligand doesn't have the power. It cannot provide that much energy which can be used to pair up. Because when electrons are paired, student, there is a pairing energy. Did we talk of that? Pairing energy, you remember? But VBT did not talk about the pairing energy. Crystal field theory talked of the pairing energy. Student, pay attention. Okay, then what will happen, students? You have 4S, 4B, 4D? Do you have? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
How many ligands are coming?
6.
6. And each will donate 1 pair of electron to the vacant. So what will be the hybridization then? SP3D? D2. So this is what type of complex is, outer or inner, students? Outer outer orbital high spin complex. So many things I'm telling you. High spin paramagnetic. And they say, what is the magnetic moment of the students? Mu is equal to square root of n plus n by 2 students. Spin magnetic moment. Do you know about this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How much value will come, students?
It will come
Bohr magneton. 4 unpaired electrons. Students, I already know the values in the paper because I am solving 10 more questions based on this. That will be around 4.9 something.
4.92.
Whatever it is. So it will be higher than that. So let me put some value around 4.9 or something. So students, we are aware if choices are given now, we know what is the approximate values of this, whatever values are coming, Bohr magneton, students. So it's slightly less than 5. We know about it. So sp3d2 hybridization, then what type of shape it has? What is the geometry?
Its geometry will be,
we have shown a table of that, students, to you. Octahedral.
Octahedral. Huh, yes, sir.
How many things I linked with that? A question could be anything. But one of these questions is coming in the paper. I know about that. Write the formula of the for the following coordinate compound. Amine bromo dichloride nitrito. Nitrito N platinate 2. You have to write the formula, students. Whatever rules we have learned, we have to use it. Important question. All these questions are very important. What we are talking, student. What are the ligands?
Bromido, amine, chloride,
NH3 is my amine, student. Bromido.
Br.
Chloride. How many? 2. Chloride. Nitrito. NO2. Students. Nitrito is NO2. N means nitrogen. Platinate means what, student? What type of complex is this? What type of complex is this, students?
It will be PT.
NH2. This is a, what type of complex is this, student?
Anionic complex.
Anionic complex. So you write first PT, then what will you write, student?
NH3.
Amine. Bro. Mido, chloride, nitrite. First is coming Br.
First is NH3.
Okay, NH3. When you write NH3, what write? Parenthesis or normal?
Parenthesis.
Okay. How many NH3 are there? One?
One.
After that?
Bromido.
Br. After that?
Chloride.
How many?
One.
Amido. Acha, one. Then why did I write two here? One. After that, students,
Nitrite O.
How will you write?
NO2.
Nitrite O.
In parenthesis. Yes, sir.
Close it.
Close and then valency minus 1.
Minus 1. What is the platinum here? Which oxidation state is that? 2.
2.
How will you get 2? You have 2. X. You have 0. You have minus 1. Minus 1. And minus 1 equal to. What is the value coming? 3.
3.
So you want 2. Then it should be equal to minus 1.
Minus 1.
See how we work out the question, student. Even slight mistake will be zero. I can't do mugging. Nothing is possible. Such questions are coming in the paper. If you do one, you can do any question. That is my point, student. Because practice is required. Because we are doing some mistakes. So by practice, our mistakes will be eliminated or minimized. Because some errors do take place when we do the questions. And those who do strong practice, then the chances of errors are less, students. Therefore, we will survive. Which isomer of this does not show optical isomerism? This is a very important complex, student. What I have written. So many questions are asked on this. This is an important complex, student. I'm telling you, very important. There will be so many questions on this side. Some questions are repeated in many exams. Can we draw the possible isomers of this? When we discussed isomerism, students, what type of isomers we discussed? Potent isomerism. Isomerism, students. What is our answer coming? What is the answer coming, student? Which isomer of this? How will we draw the isomers of this? What is the gem? This is, how do I draw, student? This is my cobalt. What type, what is the geometry of this, student? What type of complex? How do we write isomers? How to draw? Again, same thing, octahedral type. You have EN, EN, students, and CL. This is important, student. Because if I put CL here, CL here, student.
Yes, sir.
EN here, EN here. Which one is this?
It will be CL, CL, and it will be cis.
Cis isomer. Another one which we draw, student.
Trans. CO, CL.
And I put CL. Trans, student, 180 degree. 180 degree angle, students. That yes, is the catch. I know what is the angle here. 180 degree. Now, what is this trans?
Trans.
Will it, which will be optically active, students?
Cis will be optically active.
This will be optically active. We'll have a mirror image, student, which will be non-superimposable. This is chiral, student. This is a chiral, students. It has a plane of symmetry. Can you see the plane of symmetry, students? You can
yes,
see
sir.
That. It has a plane of symmetry, students. So, very important. This question is important, important, and important. must be able to work out, student, that you have to think of every question before you answer the question, students. In the following reaction, Q plus R products, the time taken for 99% reaction of Q is twice the time taken for 90% of the reaction. 90% of the reaction, students. The concentration of R varies with time as shown. What is the overall order of the reaction? Give the units of the rate constant. Write the rate expression, students. Rate expression. So, students, you see that so many things have been written in this. I said, in what type of, you studied zero order, student?
Yes, sir.
Our course, first order.
First order.
And you have derived the equations for the first order. And you have drawn the graphs also. So in first order reaction, what was the nature of the graph, students? First order reaction.
It was a straight line graph with a positive slope. If it was made between log R and
here, concentration of R he is plotting, student. Concentration of R.
It will be a zero order reaction.
Concentration of R with respect to time is given. The concentration of R varies with the concentration of, in which case the concentration varies like this, student, with the time. It is almost becoming zero at a particular time. You already know, student, you know what is the first zero for first order reaction. What is the formula? KT is equal to 2.303 log of R of 0 by R. That equation. And if you want to calculate, students, time taken for 99%. What is that time taken for 99% of the reaction? What will be that value? 99% means what? How much will be left?
1% will be left.
So if I take this one, what is that? 2.303 divided by K. Log of, what is this? If this is 1, how much is left? 0.01. If it is a 90%, what is that? 2.303 K log of, how much is left, students? 90% gone, then
0.1.
So what is the relationship? If you see, the time taken for 90% is twice. What is the relationship between T90?
T90
will be 2 times, because this is 0.1, this is log. 2 times of 99%, student. This is always true for first order. For first order reaction, the time taken for 99% reaction is twice. This is 99.
This will be 99. Yeah, 90 over by.
Okay, let me because I wanted to derive it. If you have doubt, you can derive it. This is an important formula, because in exam student, you can use it directly. Time for 99% student is equal to time for 2 times of T90. ठीक है? This is always true for which first order reaction. So the overall order of the reaction is, what do you mean by this student? 20 number question important. We know that T99% is equal to 2 times of T of 90% for first order reaction. Directly I can use it now. ठीक है? Therefore, give the what is the overall order of the reaction. Therefore, student, the overall order is first order. ठीक है?
Okay.
Second, okay. He says, give the units of rate constant for the same. Now, why did he give this value? Because write the expression, because you have to write the expression for this. Total order is one, but there are two things. Can see that? What are the units of K? For first order, what are the units of K, student?
Per second, second inverse.
Second inverse. ठीक है? Then students, what is the next question? Write the rate expression. Now, when I say the rate of the reaction, student, is equal to K Q power X and R power Y. ठीक है? Now the concentration of R with respect to time is this. What it means? Y is equal to 0. It is a zero order with respect to R. That is what this graph shows?
Yes, sir.
That graph is, then what is the final answer? Rate is equal to students K into Q. Okay?
Yes,
see, sir. The question involved some amount of we should be able to answer every question, student, then we can say. Next question, student, rate constant for first order reaction has been found. Calculate the 3/4 life. Rate constant for the first order reaction. Rate constant is given. What is the formula? Again, you have this formula. What do you have? KT is equal to 2.303 log of R0 by R student. If I take 3/4, what it means? Three-fourth life will mean what, student? 2.303 log of R0, what will be left, student, here? 1/4 R of 0. ठीक है? Log of 4. Now, rate constant K is given. You can find the value of T3/4, student.
Yes, sir.
2.303 log of 2 the square. What is the value of K? How much is K? 2.54. T3/4 is equal to 2.303 How much is K? 2.54
into 10 raised to the power minus
seconds. Then this will become into 2 log 2. So what is the answer? We have to do some simple math now. Calculate log 2 value is usually given, or we know what is log 2. Already certain values are known. 0.301. Log 3 is how much? 0.4771. I think something we know.
0.4771.
Okay. They will give if required, but we also know certain numbers, so we can use it. Numbers which we know we can use it, we don't know, then we can try. What is the answer coming then? Important question, students. Such questions are likely to be asked in the paper.
It will come to be
3/4, students. So some value we have to calculate. This you can take on the top 10^3. Calculations are not that difficult.
0.55 into 10 raised to power 3 seconds.
0.55
into 10 raised to power 3.
So that means 5.5 into 10^2. What are the units?
Seconds.
Seconds. Okay. See the questions. How do we solve it, student? After 24 hours. 24 hours. Only 0.125 gram out of the initial quantity of radioactive isotope remains. What is the half-life? These are important questions, student. Important question. Radioactive. You know, radioactive decay is a first order reaction.
Yes, sir.
Radioactive decay is a first order reaction, student. This is a first order. So, what you are saying, student? Let me change the color because important questions are coming. Such questions are likely to be there. R into P, first order. Why did I say first order radioactive decay? Everything we should know, student, before we answer a question. That is my point. What is the formula for this? KT is equal to 2.303 log of R of 0 by R, students. Okay? After 24 hours, only 0.125 gram remains. Then we... time is equal to 24 hours. 2.303 log of how much it remains? 1/0.125 remains. What will be this value? 1000/125. How much is that? 8?
1000/125, 8.
2/3. So if I take the log of this, 3 log 2. What will be that value we know? So how much it is coming, student? What is the value of K then? 2.303/24 hours into 3 log 2 is 0.301. This value is coming. How much is it coming, student? Whatever it may be, hours.
It may be
something, whatever it comes. 2.303 some hours inverse. This value.
It will be
0.087 hour inverse K. Then students, what is a T half? 0.693 by K. What is the value of K? 0.087 hours. Student, what is the answer coming?
It will be 7.97.
Then I may write 8 hours. Too.
8 hours, okay. Approximately.
See, the, this is very important. This part is very important. One of the questions is coming. So we have taken proper time in solving such questions. We are not just answering blindly, student, that okay, I know the answer, I will write. There's nothing like that. we have to show all the steps, each and every word, then only marks will be given, because a 2-mark question is split up like this, students. Half plus half plus half. So all steps, I'm always saying, student, show steps, write units to get the full marks. There are clues in every question. Numericals are good for you because you can get full marks easily. But if you will not write all the steps, if you will not write all the units, you are losing marks for your own mistake, students. Dekho, everything is important. Among the isomeric alkanes, identify the one that on photochemical chlorination yields a single monochloride. Students, single monochloride. Now, first we should be able to write the isomers of this. Questions have started coming on isomerism, student. C5H12, how many isomers can you draw, students?
This will be
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this, student, then. You have drawn, student. You can try all these, whatever are possible, students. But the one which has chlorination, only one single. The problem with, you have studied the halogenation of alkane, students. For the preparation of haloalkanes. Did you study that?
Yes, sir.
What type of mechanism was that, student? This is called a free radical.
Free radical mechanism.
Halogenation. But the problem with this was that, student, you were getting mixtures. Mixtures of haloalkanes. You are getting mixtures of haloalkanes, students?
Yes, sir.
You are getting mixtures of haloalkanes, student. Mixtures of haloalkanes. Because you are getting 1 degree, 2 degree, or depending on the what type of hydrogens are present. But then which case you will get only one?
The third case.
In this, if I put
2-2-dimethylpropane.
All these hydrogens are equal. You can replace only because mono product is being formed. Single monochloride, he's saying. Single monochloride. So this will be the answer for us, student. We can write the possibilities, but we know which. Once we get the answer, we can easily and give the reason also. Draw the structure of 4-tertiary-butyl-3-idoheptane, student. 4-tertiary-3-idoheptane. 4-tertiary-3-idoheptane, student. You have to draw the structure. What is the carbon root? Root of the carbon, heptane. How many carbons are there in heptane? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And you are saying you have to write 3. If I start from here, students, 3 idol, For T butyl, what is that T butyl? That was the only reason he gave the question because students will be troubling that. What is T butyl? You have one, two, three. Here are the students doing some mistakes, students. Now we can complete it. Complete it, students. Every question take time for answering a question. We don't have to hurry up, student. We don't have to hurry up any of the question, students, because we will lead to certain difficulties and problems. I already told you certain questions are coming on drawing the structures of the compound, student, structures and oxo acids of sulfur are important, students. We have already told you how to draw the structures of oxo acids of sulfur, students. And once you know what type of hybridization is taking place, we can do it, students, and draw the structures of these. What is that? Pyro. What is that called? Oleum. Is pyro sulfuric acid. Pyro sulfuric acid, student, pyro. And we told you what pyro means. This type of linkage will be there. Pyro. And each sulfur, you already know each sulfur, student, is what hybridization in the sulfur. You are aware of the hybridization, students. Sulfur. You have drawn it so many times. Sulfur, how many are there in sulfur? Six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electrons, students. Then what will happen? You already know. Oxygen double bond should be there, and there are 2H. So if I put student OH, OH, then what is left? You know about it? Got it?
Yes, sir.
So each oxygen is forming, student, double bond. Oxygen here, one and one with this one here, double. And this oxygen is again forming two bonds. So you can see that 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. That is sulfur. Pyrosulfuric acid has been asked many times, student, in the structures. And XeOF4, already you know how you draw the structure of xenon oxyfluoride. Xenon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 4, 6, and 8, students. And this oxygen forms a double bond, you know, and 1, 2, 3, 4 fluorines. And there will be total, you can see how many bond pairs, 1, 2, 5, and one lone pair. 5 bond pair and one lone pair, student, total 6. Then what is that? You are aware that octahedral, but one will be occupied by the lone pair. So what shape it will take, student? Structure. You have, I'll write batter. And there is a lone pair. What shape it is then? What is this called? Square? Pyramidal. Each sulfur is sp3 hybridized here. Give test to distinguish CH3, CH double bond, C, CH3, CH2, Cl. ठीक है, एंड दिस सी एच थ्री सी एच टू सी एल actually he wants to see the reactivity of Cl, which Cl is most reactive here. What type of this is allyl? Allyl chloride. This is normal propyl chloride, and this is vinyl, that carbon dash to this Cl. This is not going to react with aegean HNO3. This will react very fast with AgNO3, and this will react but much slower than this, so you may have to warm it. Name the crystal defect which reduces the density of an ionic solid. What type of ionic substances show this effect, students? What is the name of the defect?
This reduces the density of an ionic solid. For ionic solid, Schottky defect.
Schottky, equal number of cations, ions are missing. We know about it, students, and examples you know, which shows
examples are NaCl, KCl, AgBr,
silver alkali halides. You know they have almost equal size.
Yes, sir.
What type of ionic substances which have equal size of the almost equal size of the cation and anion?
Yes, sir.
Almost equal size of cations and anions, students. Cations and anions. Equal size of cations and anions. Equal size of cations and, like NaCl. The size are almost equal, they will show. All right, students, these are some of the important questions which have been discussed. Then we will meet you next time and see what more is possible in the coming board papers and in other exams. And okay, then good night. We'll see you in the next class.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay.